Hello. Previously, we have talked about the capacity rating of FLT and the energy ratings of FLT. Now, on the discussion basis on that thing, we are now going to solve one or two numericals. Okay. So, the first numerical, if you go through the question properly, see, FLT, which is used in a warehouse, have a rated capacity of 4000 kg. The load center is at 450 mm, and distance between the heel of the fork to the front wheel is 350 mm. What will be the true capacity? Now, if you properly go through the total previous notes, then you will find that this rated capacity is given by the manufacturer, and the load center means load center is the distance from the heel of the fork to the CG or load center point on the load. Okay, and the distance between heel of the fork to the front wheel means the front wheel center point of the front wheel, that is given is 350 mm. So if you go through that proper formula, you will find that we have to find the true capacity, that true capacity that is equal to the rated capacity. Now what is the rated capacity? The rated capacity is over here 4000 into the distance of the load center, which is 450, plus distance from the heel of the fork to the front wheel, which is 350. And by calculating this, we'll find the answer will be around 32 into 10 to the power 5 kg mm. So this is the true capacity of this FLT. Now, apart from this, we can also find out the safe weight. Now, for finding out this safe weight, we know that formula where safe weight we can find. Now, safe weight of the FLT. Now you know that safe weight is the maximum weight which is carried by the FLT, and this safe weight, you must know about that, this safe weight must be lower than that of the rated capacity, just to, because it can counterbalance the load with the weight of the forklift truck. Okay, so finding out the FLT, we have to do this thing. Now, the safe weight, finding out the safe weight of the FLT, the formula is just like this, that is the true capacity divided by distance of CG plus the distance from heel to fork. So now see, the distance of CG is not given. So if we assume, assuming the distance of CG, suppose 550 mm. Now, if we assume this part, obviously this thing will be given in the question, but for this we are assuming the distance of CG over here. So if we assume the distance of the CG from the heel of the fork is about 550 mm, then its safe weight will be true capacity, that is 32 into 10 to the power 5 by distance of the CG, that is 550, plus distance from the heel of the fork, that is 350. So if we calculate this, the answer will be about 3555.56 kg. Now see, if we see, this is 355.56 kg. Now this thing, this is the safe weight. So if you see, this safe weight is actually much lower than of this rated capacity. Now if we try to find out what is the relationship between the safe weight and the rated capacity, then relationship between safe weight means maximum safe weight with rated capacity will find that safe weight W, maximum safe weight W is 0.88 into T, means the rated capacity. T rated. Okay. So this is the actual relation between safe weight with the rated capacity. Now coming to the next problem. A battery operated FLT of 4000 pound carrying a weight of 2000 pound lifting load of 2 feet while traveling a 200 feet distance. The path is divided into two sections, one having 30 feet inclined road upwards with 6% inclination. After unloading, it comes back to the same path. Find the total energy required for one duty cycle. Now there is a table given where you can see weight. Total weight means the load of the truck and load of the material included. Feet means length of the run, and battery rating is given, and feet in length of the run is given like 100 feet and 200 feet. Okay, now total weight is given 4000 and 6000. Now coming back to this problem, see, first one, it is giving the weight of truck, that is 4000 pound, and material load, that is 2000 pound. Okay, then total load, that is 6000 pound. Now see, this truck is actually going, if I draw this pattern of its movement, then it is going 170 feet going 170 feet then with 6% inclination it is going again 30 feet, then it is lifting 2 feet is going again, it is coming back to its original position. So A is the position of the starting, B is the position of unloading, C is the point where the path becomes inclined. Okay, so A to C, this path is actually horizontal path, and C to B, this path is actually inclined path. Now we have to calculate separately for horizontal path. Now for horizontal path, we can directly get from this chart by interpolating interpolation method, we can get what is the watt hour required for this 4000 and 6000. Now why we are doing two times, now three. Now see properly. If you see properly, first of all, when the truck is fully loaded with material, it is going from this point to this point, from A to B. Now when it is running from A to B with material, its total load becomes 6000. Now when it is coming back from B to A, its total load become 4000, just because it has already unloaded the material load of 2000 pound. Okay, so we have to solve it in two section. So first section, that is the half duty cycle from A to B. Okay, so from A to B, total load, that is 6000 LVS. Energy required for 170 feet. By interpolation method, we have found out for 170 feet, that is 21.3 watt hour. Okay, how we'll do that thing? If we think 170 feet, watt hour is x, then x will be equal to 170 minus 100 into 24 minus 15 by 200 minus 100 plus 15. So by this way we can find out it will become 21.3. Okay, so energy required for 170 feet, that is 21.3 watt hour. Now the next thing, for 30, this rest 30 feet, energy required for upgradation, that is equal to 6000, that is total load, by material load 2000 into 30 means the distance of inclination into percentage of inclination into 0.013, which is constant term. So by this, solving this, we'll find 7.02 watt hour. The next thing, that is, see, it have reached this point B. Now the next thing, what is to be done, that is lifting the load and putting the load in the stack. So lifting energy is required. So lifting energy that is equal to, so what is the load, total load, that is 2000 by material load, again 2000 into 2 means the height of lift, that is 2 into 2 constant term, so it will become 4 watt hour. Then total energy required for A to B or half cycle, that is equal to 21.3 plus 7.02 plus 4, that is equal to 32.2 3.2 watt hour. Okay, now the next thing, number 2, return from B to A. Now the total load, that is 4000 pound. So number 1, number 1 will be, see, already the fork have been lifted, so if I go to this return cycle, then first of all we need to find out the lifting energy. Lifting energy means here is the lifting energy will be free lift. Now lifting energy required, that is free lift means 1/3 of the total lifting energy. That means total lifting energy is 4 watt hour. So it will be 4/3 watt hour, or you can see 4/3 means 1.33 watt hour. Number 2, now energy for downgrade travel, that will be 0. Why 0? Because we already know that if the upgradation percentage is more than 2, then when the FLT is going down, no energy will be required, because we will apply gravity principle to bringing down that FLT from top position to bottom. Okay, so energy for downgrade travel, that will be 0 watt hour. Now, third, traveling feet. Now first, for this half duty cycle total load was 6000. We have to interpolate for this value. Now we have to interpolate the same thing for this value, that means using 10 and 16. If we change these two value, 16 and 10, and it will become 10, then the value will become 14.2 watt hour. Then we have to, then it is coming back to this point, A point. So total energy required, sorry, for from P to A, that is equal to lifting energy 1.33 plus 14.2, that is 15.53 watt hour. Okay, then total energy for full duty cycle, that is, one is this one, 32.32, plus another one is this one, 15.53. So that will be equal to 47.85 watt hour. Okay.